What's up, everybody? I hope you all are having a great day today. Today, Jamila and I are gonna post this video. This is Vlogmas Day 4. And what we're deciding to do today is an individualized video with me and how I like to be a great husband. And next week when Jamila comes back, she's gonna explain how she feels like she is a great wife. The reason why I say feels is because Jamila and I, we both have areas that we are working on. We are newlyweds, we are 7 months in. We got married this current year, March 31st. So within this video, I'm going to be giving you all my philosophy, my perspective on how I feel like I am a great husband. But I appreciate you all for watching. And we're about to go ahead and get things rolling. It is now 1 o'clock, so I'm about to go ahead and hurry up and make this video because I got to shoot back and be back to the school in about 40 minutes. I have an article that I read. I have it bookmarked and saved in my phone because as a newlywed, there are things that I try to do to make sure that I'm a great husband. So I kind of use these tools to self-check and analyze, am I doing what I feel is necessary in my marriage with Jamila to make sure that I'm treating her as best as possible, because at the end of the day, I want to make sure that our lives are enriched and we are living our life to the fullest throughout our marriage. So I'm gonna go ahead and drop a link within the description to let you all know what article I'm reading. But the name of the article is 17 Ways to Know If You're Being a Great Husband Within Your Relationship. Hopefully something that I share with you all can maybe make you have a conversation with yourself. Or am I doing these things? So for the first one, development of a moral compass. And what they mean by that is, as a husband, as a man within your relationship, do you have an established philosophy of life within your marriage? For me, I feel like this is so essential. Does your wife know what you stand for in life? And I feel like this communication is key, because the husband has a philosophy, the wife has a philosophy, and it is you all's job to make sure that you all mesh, coexist with each other in order to help each other achieve the philosophy. And I feel like if you all are married, you should be agreeing with each other's philosophy. You are placed into each other's life, not only on a emotional, spiritual, and physical sense, but you all also need to be driving each other's goals and philosophy of how you view life. Number two is a big one. And I know, ladies, if you're watching this, you can attest to this, but I feel like every woman loves a confident man. Number two talks about believing in yourself. Why would your wife believe in you if you don't believe in yourself? Now, there's a difference between believing in yourself and needing someone to help support you. Because I'm not going to lie, there are times that I get down and, you know, Jamila, my wife, does a great job of uplifting my spirit. But within my relationship, I feel it makes me a great husband when she knows that I'm confident. Like, I don't want Jamila to have any time of period where she's experiencing doubt within our marriage, because me, the husband who's supposed to be the head of the household, I want to let Jamila know this is what I want to do and this is what it takes. And I feel like if I go ahead and establish that she knows at the end of the day, my husband has a goal and my husband is willing to do whatever it takes, whether it's losing sleep, whether it's sacrificing fun time in order to get this job done. So as a man, and to all my fellows who may be watching this, please be confident within yourselves. But if you need help, your wife is there to help you. Number three, I'm gonna read this directly because I don't want to mess up paraphrasing this. But number three, it says to know yourself. No man is perfect. Therefore, no husband is perfect, no matter how good of a husband he is. Take inventory of your strengths, your weaknesses, your bad habits, and unrealistic expectations of your marriage. And although you aren't perfect, recognize that you can still strive for excellence. Jamila and I always have conversations of where can I improve on. There's a saying that a person who feels like they're perfect is far from it. I know I'm not perfect. I want to be a person that always focus on the positive. I focus a lot on a lot of negatives, and I try to excuse it by saying I'm just being realistic about things. Like, no, you have to be careful what you place into the atmosphere with your mind. So those areas are my weaknesses. I constantly want to improve. Always take your problems head on, because if you keep trying to brush them under the rug and you have kids, guess what? Now your kids gonna have your same problems. Recycling within the generation. It's a generational curse. Who did you get your problems from? Where did they get their problems from? And when you can get it from, knit it from the bud, you can go ahead and break that generational curse and go on forth. Everything should be much smoother. All right, number four, to kind of lighten things up. Fellas, please know your wife. Jamila, I know she has pet peeves. I know she likes things a certain way, so I always try to make sure and maintain healthiness within our relationship. And they have a cute phrase that goes with this. Besides know your wife is always right. I'm trying to learn this, and I'm learning it the hard way, that sometimes you just have to say, okay, honey, no matter how wrong they are, your wife is gonna be wrong. And it's gonna take time for them to come around and apologize, and they're not gonna apologize directly. They're going to say, you know what? You remember when you said this? Let's try it that way. Or they'll try to address it up some type of way so they don't have to apologize. But fellas, please know your wife. I know Jamila in the morning. I know when she gets up, she has the time limit of when she's gonna get out the house. I like to go ahead and start a car up because she wanted me to. I didn't naturally do that. I know the things that ticks her off. If the wife is unhappy, the whole house is unhappy. So please, please, please make sure that your wife is taken care of. So I start my wife's car in the morning. I make her car, make sure her car is warmed up, especially in the cold months. Make sure she has a water in her bag because I know she does a lot of talking through teaching. I make sure that anything that she needs is in the house. If you see that your wife is stressed out, I try to alleviate some of those pressures from her. A lot of times we get stuck in gender roles. In our house, we don't have any gender roles. So if I know she's stressed out, she's busy, I wouldn't mind washing the clothes. I don't mind washing the dishes. I don't mind cleaning up, dusting, vacuuming. I don't mind doing those things. I know my wife is putting in a lot of work, and at the end of the day, make sure that you are hearing your wife. Our wives, at the end of the day, just want to be heard. And if you know that your wife likes to talk, and she has different ways of her form of communication, make sure that you hear her out. Like, know your wife. Know when she feels bothered. Know by without her saying that she had a bad day. Know without her saying that she's hungry. Know without saying that she needs something. You should be able to pick up on patterns to where she doesn't even have to ask for anything. And it doesn't have to be like a monetary ask. It could just simply be something that she needs in order for her to feel better about her day. I feel like, man, we gotta understand, like, we get so stuck in ourselves. I can't speak for everybody, but for me, I can get so overwhelmed in my day that I can forget that, shoot, my wife is going through her own separate day. So I always try to make sure and ask her how she's doing and make sure that she knows that I care about her and that I'm always there for her. All right, number five, please make sure that you prioritize your relationship. I make it my duty. Whatever is going on, she's going to feel like it's first. What's the Bible say? Every boy or man shall leave and create his own family. My wife comes before my mom. My wife comes before my brother, my dad, my grandmother, anybody, my job, anything. There's been times where Jamila got stranded and I'll call up my department chair and be like, hey, I gotta go pick up my wife. Her tire just went flat or her car won't start. And it's like, nothing comes before your wife. Always make sure that you keep the integrity of your marriage by letting your wife know that she matters first and she always comes first. Now, there's still some things that I gotta do a better job of. Like, if I'm out in public, like, I'll hold the door for my wife and there's a lady behind me, I'll still hold the door for her and she gives me that look like, you don't come on. Always put your wife first, fellas. All right, next one, fight for your relationship. I know, guys, we are very prideful. I know this. I am so prideful. And if you believe in horoscopes, I'm a Leo, so I'm super prideful. We gotta bite our pride at times and fight for the relationship. There are times that Jamila and I will argue. No matter how much we argue or no matter what she says, I'm like, Jamila, you are wrong. You are so wrong. And it's like, as men, we gotta understand, men and women are not wired the same. We think on one wavelength. They can think on another wavelength, and sometimes beautiful things happen and we think on the same path. But it doesn't always happen. And we gotta humble ourselves, and I'm doing a better job with this, but a lot of times I try to be the first to apologize for something. I try to say, you know what, Jamila, I apologize for doing this, that, and the third. I hate when she has to bring up, why haven't you apologized to me this? Fight for your relationship. No matter if you feel like you're right, if you feel like you're wrong. All right, and the last one, kind of wrap things up. I have a bonus one for you all that I want to share with you. But please, please, please make sure that y'all drop comments in the comment section. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Can you expand on something that I have stated? But the seventh one that I want to go ahead and share is always make sure that you pray. You know, it's times where it's not easy. You know, it's times that I gotta go to God. Like the other day, for example, Jamila and I, we were about to record a sit-down video. And right before we recorded a sit-down video, we got into this petty disagreement, which pretty much almost, y'all almost didn't get a sit down last week. I went ahead and went upstairs and I went ahead and prayed and I came back downstairs and everything was fine. Make sure within your relationship that you are constantly praying. Pray that you all can understand each other and communicate more healthy. I pray for my wife's health and overall a well, healthy person. And I feel like that is so, you know, so key within a relationship. You know, they say a family that prays together stays together. Yeah, it's cliche, but at the same time, it's also true. Other than that, y'all, I truly appreciate you all sticking it through with me throughout this video. I'm allow you all to investigate on your own. So in the description, I went ahead and posted a link. It's from MSN. And it's 17 ways how to become a greater husband, a greater man within your marriage. You asked her to be your wife. She didn't ask you. It's your responsibility to take care of her, no matter how crazy she might be. I know these women out here crazy. They crazy. But you gotta take care of your wife through thick and thin, through health, through sickness, through rich and through poor. You gotta make sure that your wife comes first and that you have her back no matter what. And I appreciate you all for joining, and we will see you all tomorrow on our travel tips. So subscribe if new. We got stuff posted every single day of the week. I'm gonna go ahead and stop talking, and I'll see y'all next time. Peace.